Bang! Caught you looking for the same thing.
I sit alone in my four-cornered room eating a wing dinner.
Let's celebrate our music here before it's too late.
Let's get it.
What's up, everybody? Encyclopedia Hip Hop Podcast. I'm your host, Eclectic. We're back for the ladies. We're doing for the ladies where we spotlight women and rhyme that's super dope, that get overlooked or forgotten, or, hey, some of you people never even heard of. So we spotlight them. And hopefully you go back and listen and stream and give them their props if you run into them or see them on social media or something. This episode, we're doing Antoinette. Antoinette Lavelle Patterson, or Banks. No, she got married. The Gangstress. The Gangstress from the Bronx. She debuted around 1987. She was on Next Plateau. Same label as Ultra Mag. Salt and Pepper. It was the Herbie label. Herbie Love Bug. Herbie Azor. Speaking of which, the first time I heard her was on Herbie's Machine, the house that Rap built. Had Hit Him With This. I think it was the first song. Hit Him With This. Crazy.
Call me a vocalist, a vocal extraordinaire. And if you ain't heard that, then just pull up a chair. Don't need a countdown, just a steady beat to be born. And I'ma go for mine. But first, let me inform. I rock it just quick. And your ducks will get stuck. That's right, step in my path. And you're gonna get struck. Cause when I'm holding this and I like the tempo, I'll take control from the end to my intro. Hit like a heartbeat, never out of sync. Each rhyme is the chain and my voice is the link. So I make them connect, then I rehearse and perfect. Recite them on wax so that I can collect. I make your paper come through, you know I'm hard to trust. You had enough, I thought so I could see the lust. If you want me to go on, my rhyme just flow on. The only time I pause is for my DJ to throw on another hit, a little harder and louder. When I drop the mic, they come up and say howdy. Hell, I keep the pace with the serious face. Still the crowd like
after that song, I was in love. She was basically the female version of Rakim. This is 87. Rakim came out in 87. I heard women rhyme, of course, Shantae and Salt and Pepper, but I never heard women rhyme like this. This was crazy. Almost, I haven't heard women rhyme like that since. Maybe Rod Digger a little close, but Antoinette, voice smooth, flow sick, delivery was out of here. And that album also had I Got an Attitude, the classic. You heard Meth.
Mad at you, where I used to battle crews. Back when Antoinette had that attitude.
That's where that came from.
Orally, potent, lethal, but steady. Man, your battle stations, I'm ready. Cold getting bigger, an idol-like figure. Play me if you want, and make like a trigger. Squeeze it the best. You can huff and puff, but it's kiddie stuff. Because your best ain't good enough. Stand at attention, your body in line. This ain't your average rhyme. If it is, it ain't mine. Ducks, has-beens, I'ma show them all. I'm not a joker, but I laugh. Cause y'all can't brawl. I roll the mic smokes, I lay it to rest. Embalmed in my palm, I touch it and it's blessed. Got style, I know the routine. All punks popping jump, can't join my team. I got an attitude.
But I played those two songs out. Hit them with this. I Got an Attitude on Herbie's Machine, the house the Rap built. Side note, it also had I Am Down by Salt and Pepper, which might have been Salt and Pepper's last dope song. You know, you had all of High Cool and the Vicious, then I Am Down. Other than that, everything sucks. I digress. So Antoinette, she dropped two albums. She had Who's the Boss in 89 and Burning at 20 Below in 1990. Now, before we get to the albums, let's address the beef. The MC Light Battle, which I have an entire episode on, so go check that out, go listen to that. But to put it quickly, the beef was one-sided. It came from nowhere. MC Light and her camp, Audio 2 and First Priority, manufactured it out of nowhere, trying to capture the UTFO, Roxanne Flame, or the Kumo D, Kool J joint. Light basically said that she stole the top billing beat for I Got an Attitude. Now, one, that's a beef with Herbie. She didn't produce that track. She just rhymed over it. And two, she didn't bite the beat. And three, MC Light bit the beat on the song dissing Antoinette for biting the beat. So shut up. Anyway, Antoinette responded, lyrically bodied Light. I mean, lyrically, I Got an Attitude is better than every MC Light song lyrically, including Cha Cha Cha, which she didn't write. Anyway, the problem was Antoinette wasn't as well known as MC Light, so most of those songs that she fired back went mostly unnoticed, except for by me. Light had literally nothing on her except fame. You know, rhymes, beats, looks, Antoinette won. Maybe Light dressed better. I did like the MC Light jacket. That jacket was dope. And didn't she have a Shirt Kings joint? Now, Audio 2 had a Shirt Kings joint. I don't remember. Anyway, the battle went on for like 5 songs or so. And Antoinette won. Lyrically, she won. Court of public opinion, probably not because everyone liked MC Light. They still like MC Light. She's the voice of BET Awards, which sucks. Anyway, Antoinette also dropped the radio joint with Big Daddy Kane, which was dope. Look. As it goes a little something like this. It's me, you see, the B-I-G, the D-A-D-D-Y-B-I, the K-A-N-E. Excited, delighter, invite a biter, the fighter, do fools so I can school and rule and ignite a party to the climax, the mic I wax. You know who the true lord is, so why act? Rhymes I deliver, always come with a unique technique when I speak, and if a sucker will step to me, he will be left to be lost in jeopardy, cause I will set you free. Just run up on stage and take a stand, broad, snatch the mic, a victim like a landlord. For me to go out, I can't have it, so set the microphone up just for me to grab it. Then just allow the Big Daddy to center hit, cause when I run up on stage, yo, I'm a demo with crash and bash and crash and slash and mash, clock cash, as I wax much ass. The lyrics I'm displaying, the suckers are obeying, cause this is all live hives, know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that was fresh, but yo, you gotta bust this.
What you got for me, baby?
I got a lot.
Set it off. Ah.
Sit up, get up, the eighth gonna light up. News reporters, get ready for the write-up. Tell them in your mag how the set was a drag till I came. I'm not trying to brag, I just pour, tour, rhyme, and climb. I go prime time because I go for mine. I never fake, break, take, make, shake, and bake. Drop my groove until your back ache. So be my victim, scream, kick, and holler. A fresher rhyme will follow, cause I'm a scholar. I do what I gotta do. And when I'm through, take a trip to the Bahamas. Come back and continue to say only the hype then extra exotic.
Molly, hit me now.
Yo, Ken, you want it, you got it.
Yeah, that sounds funky. Yo, I think this is the dope promo for Hot Chillin', man.
Yo, you know what you call this? You call this a raw attitude.
What? So, yo, what's up? We out of here.
Show me a woman that was going to go toe-to-toe and hold her own rhyming with Big Daddy Kane in 88, 89. Exactly. So, Who's the Boss, the first album, had some dope songs. The title track, Who's the Boss, The Gangstress, Lights Out, Party's Over, this and MC Light. That one was good. The lyrics were a 10. The production for an 89 joint was about a 7, but they should have done her better. Had Watch the Gangstress Boogie. She got off on that. She had the slow joints, then the fast G-rap Kane type shit, like Off on Her Own.
When I take a stand, so you better be a dancer, cause rappers are blowing forward more. Oh, yo, now the knockout pro is here to kick and pick the two to sing. You think you fly, yo, I'll break your wing. You can't storm or transform or run for cover, cause rhymes will break the door. So who's the fool who wants to jump to death? Bring the bass and pipe and watch the step, cause the champ will stamp and trample you in it. Quite humorous. Now who can take and make a step to my debonair rhyme that kept you hyperactive with the dope or fix the hit? I'm paid in full to save that ball. I know, they know, he know, we know, you know.
Here she comes, nasty. She gave us the slow song, I'm Crying, because you had to have the sensitive 90s joint.
His words, I'd always believe him to be a liar. Was not on my mind, but you know his girls, huh, I was blind.
A for Antoinette and the Gangstress. The Gangstress might as well have Rakim rhyming on it with her.
Don't nobody move. Verse one, the first phase, sets a blaze. A point blank range, so I just won't blaze. I'm here to show the way, blow away, blow away, cause I know a way. I'm here to stay, so I
super dope. Now, everything wasn't great. Baby Make It Boom? Absolutely not. It was awful. Shouts to Kwame, though. But if you heard Kwame when he came on the show, you'd understand what I... Anyway, but she was raw. She was super raw. She had mad videos. She had a video for Who's the Boss. She had a video for Shake, Rattle, and Roll, the backyard cookout party joint. Never Get Enough. She had former guests of the show, Spinderella, in that video. Had the DC Swing in it. And she made sure that we knew she had the backside. Like, it was there. It was there. MC Light even commented on it. Like, yo, you got a fat ass. But she was making it like it was a diss. Trust me, it was not a diss. Also in her videos, like, she was always taking somebody out. She was really the boss. She was the gangstress. She operates around the clock. They had the walkie-talkies. I thought they were cell phones at the time. I was like, she rich. But yeah, every video she was taking somebody out off the shelf. So 1990s joined the second album, Burning at 20 Below. Less raw. It was like they tried to make her into something else instead of just like a super dope rhymer. It was like Paid in Full to Don't Sweat the Technique, but worse. Like, it was no Herbie this time, and we could hear it. They had Mantronix. Shouts to Kurt Mantronix. They didn't mix well. They didn't have chemistry. There was a couple of highlights. The Fox That Rocks the Box. That's an MC Light. And Let's Take It From the Top. And Never Get Enough was on there, too. So those were highlights. I think just about everything else you could miss. She was still rhyming, but it was just, it wasn't what we needed to be. And that was the 1990 joint, and we didn't hear from her again until she appeared on The Dirty 30, the album by Crew, 1997. So it was like a 7-year nothing, and then she dropped this. Hey, yeah, bring up your weight, make moves, stay to stay, no debate. Dancing has been hot since 88, but niggas floor since I made Who's the Boss, big yo, had the storm. Now the Holocaust is mad drama, mad scammer, drinking Bahama mamas, eating niggas up like Jeffrey Dahmer. Illegal self, dirty gaps, niggas ducking down from the claps, no shorts, no hats. Sitting pretty like Francis Lenny, forgive me, New York shit is in me, mad love for my city. Or hear the queen of the sea. So after that, stepped away from rhyming. She graduated from college, which is super dope. Wish a lot of MCs would go to college, go to school, attend school, her to school. But she went, graduated from college, became an accountant. Super dope. Nice with numbers. Now she's a motivational speaker. I go get motivated by Antoinette. She's an author. She wrote her memoirs, All That Glitters. So that's dope. Super dope woman, on and off the microphone. So I had to do this. Listen, she's probably my second, Shantae over everybody, because she's the reason why I love hip hop. But Shantae, Antoinette, Rodiga, those are my three. That's three of my personal Rushmore. I don't know who the fourth is, probably Foxy. Anyway, had to do this for Antoinette because she's super nice. Listen, go back, stream her stuff, go find it on YouTube, go find it on Spotify, Apple, wherever you can, and just listen to the lyrics. Listen to her flow. she's bodying people right now, some 30 years, 40 years later. I'm just, if you don't believe me, go listen. And we're going to do more for the ladies. Shouts to everyone that gave positive feedback on the last one we did. Boss, Lachelle Laws, Boss with two S's, $2. And we got a lot more. But go back and listen to the other ones. You know, everything is evergreen. If you love hip-hop, you'll love all the episodes. And in the meantime, in between time, we out of here. Hip-hop. Go listen to Antoinette.
Meaning hype sound. I get deep to swim on. You might drown. In 88, I was a candidate. You animated like a cartoon. So treat me like a savage with a harpoon. You go Rambo, I go commando. In other words, Antoinette isn't command. So at ease, my DJ is scratched like she got fleas. If I depended on a letter, I'd be pulling G's. Not an F, cause the gangstress is stay deaf. And sell till there's nothing left. Now I'm not talking drugs or Bacardi. And you know what's up when the boss is in the party. And they tried to piss me, 10% can't diss me. They tried to swing, but hot sis, you miss me. Your paper thin rhymes is lighter than dimes. The sign of the times is Antoinette will hit a note like a bass line. Queen of queens, yo, this means I don't need a king. It's my thing, so yo, let's swing. This is how it should be done. Antoinette will damage them until the damage is done.